So what are we doing?
So you want to cook some mustard roasted fish?
Yes.
You're a cook, right? Yeah, I think you're a cook. Okay, so first I've got snapper. This is 2 16-ounces. You can use 4 8-ounces. And it's still got the skin on. It's got all the bones taken out. Just put them in a dish. And now I'm going to make a sauce from creme fraiche, mustard, shallots. Do you want to cut a shallot for me?
Sure.
Oh, good. So I need 2 tablespoons of shallot.
Okay.
So first,
you're not going to criticize my technique if it's bad, is it?
I'm not going to criticize your
promise?
Technique at all. I promise. So far, you're doing a really good job.
2 tablespoons.
2 tablespoons. Minced shallots. So I'm going to take 8 ounces of creme fraiche. This is a really thick sort of clotted cream that's great for making sauces. And I'm going to add lots of mustard.
So which book is this from?
This is from Back to Basics. It's a really simple recipe. And it's great for beginning cooks.
You said you want these minced?
Yeah. That'd be perfect. So 3 tablespoons of mustard. And I measure everything exactly because
that's
you want to make sure it comes out right.
I still don't fully believe that
you don't believe it?
That you're not just scooping it out as you want.
I want to make
that
sure
seems
it's
right.
Exactly right. No, this what seems right is exactly the right amount. And actually I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of coarse mustard because I actually want something not only to taste like what it is, but to look like what it is. So I'm going to whisk this all together. Do you want to hand me salt and pepper? It's right next to you. I always have it on the counter. You know, one of the things I do is I always have ingredients right out so that you're ready, you know, they're there when you want to use them. But also, at some point I go, oh, you know, lemon might be good in this or something else. So
you'll take inspiration from what's just sitting around.
Just sitting there, exactly. You always feel like, oh, there must be something would be, it needs a little extra something. And you go, oh, lime, it's right there. Okay, salt and pepper. And then I'm going to add some capers, 2 teaspoons of capers, drained. You're doing a beautiful job, I have to tell you.
You're just saying that.
I'm not at all. Fantastic. Okay. The capers actually give it a nice edge. I think vinegar in things or lemon, that kind of edge really kind of wakes up the flavors in something. So
now, when you go back, I mean, this is a few books back, do you remember when you first made this recipe?
You know, after 1,000 recipes, it's hard to remember all of them. But actually, this one comes from my hairdresser in Paris.
Is that
amazingly.
Right?
Amazingly. She told me how to make it, and I thought, that's the easiest thing in the world. I'm going home and making it right now.
That's
gorgeous. Okay, I need 2 tablespoons.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Is that enough mince
for
you?
Yeah, that's fabulous.
Okay, it's all yours.
You really know how to cook. I'm very impressed. Do you cook at home?
I do. I do, and I force my kids to do it as well.
Why do I think they love it?
In fact, amazingly, my son took a stab at making this exact dish. It's pretty exciting.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
And I picked the same
dish? Just somewhat recently.
And how'd he do?
Honestly, it was, I think he
it
substituted.
It was fabulous, right?
It was fabulous.
That's the right answer.
It was fabulous.
No substitutions are allowed. That's wonderful. So I'm just going to pour this on top. And spread it out. I mean, it's pretty easy, right?
It smells so good.
All that mustard, and actually what this does is it makes a sauce. So this
in the pan after it cooks.
Yeah, because the fish and when it cooks together, this goes into the oven, 425 degrees for about 12 to 15 minutes.
I mean, this took,
that's
what, all of six
really,
minutes to put together?
Well, I had 2 people. I had somebody chopping shallots perfectly.
Okay, 10 minutes.
10
minutes. Okay.
That was pretty easy, right?
Yeah.
Okay. How's that look for mustard roasted fish?
Fantastic.
See, it makes a sauce too. Do you think anybody will notice if we just taste it?
I don't think so.
Just a little corner, nobody will notice, right? So this is snapper, mustard roasted fish.
Gosh, it smells so good.
From the hairdresser in Paris.
Does she get credit?
To you. Yeah, she does.
Cheers.
Not bad. Mm. Not good?
No, really good.
It's got a lot of flavor, but you can still taste the fish. It doesn't overpower it.
Mm, that is really good.
Thank you.
Can I have another bite?
You can have as much as you like.
This is the best job.
Isn't it? This is what I get to do for a living. Isn't it unbelievable?
It's fantastic.
Yeah, I love the layers of flavor. You really taste the mustard. And also you can see that it's mustard from the mustard seeds. And the capers add a little bit of a sort of a vinegary edge, which is nice.
Mm-hmm.
It's perfectly seasoned. If I do say so myself. So now your son can make it for you perfectly.
I can't wait to take this home.